Greetings, welcome back to Pyre. Let's continue our journey towards there, the Hulk of Ores. Hopefully we'll not track someone else's card again. Oh, what's that?
Sarambilios.
The Hulk of Ores. It has drifted here upon the sea for longer than one might expect. Perhaps we have already rid of the doomed ship, the knights, and the embrace of unfathomable plans. Some say it was the sea itself which preserves the ship's remains, even properties within the water, sea creatures binding together in the plank's root. For those such as yourselves and the essence know another truth, I gather. The stars would not align over the wreckage if it did not have the greater significance. And things appears. May you have good fortune there during the coming night. Let's go here. You touch down there at the Sea of Souls, where you first encounter Sylveumal and the Pyrehearts. You soon shall carry on by sea, but for now, you have some time to spare. Sea of Souls. Beyond a shallow, sickly gulf, our voyage grew increasingly forbidding and much harder to explain. How could a sea exist here at the bottom of the world? We could not deduce whence sprang the carcasses of ancient sailing ships we found throughout the Sea of Souls, though the warnings that they signified we duly noted. It was here we first met Ores, called the Under King, who brazenly assaulted our small skiff, for we had trespassed in his waters. But then the Under King relented, for he witnessed Solin Mor in all his doom and glory. Soon he would side with us. Then, with the Under King, we sailed forth into the tempest beyond resuming all measure. Why, hello, my lovely Vida, what may I do for you? Oh, that can be arranged. You need but a name for me, the one you have in mind. You ask Sandra to administer one of special trials for him. I must admit, I do sense something from that one. I once had a wild heart myself, quite like her own. We shall see if there is more to her than that. Let us bring her forth. Soon, Fae arrives in her in heat of the summons. Scribes, I think that if I listen carefully, that I can hear them calling out to me. The apparition Sandra appears and unfastens her mask. Listen well, girl. The place where you reside at present has but a single rule, which is, you uncertain me here. Well, okay, I will. Such an enthusiasm. Now, be silent. It is plain to me that you have much to learn as yet about the rites, but you have learned something, and I would see you prove it, for the benefit of anyone, save for your reader. Okay, are you out there to help me with this mess? That was easy. I'm back to the... The wound was pretty... Okay, how did I do? How did I do? I must admit that you did better than I had expected, girl. You have passed this trial of yours. Some congratulations are in order. To you, and also to your lovely reader. Now, farewell. Did I imagine all that mess? Because I hope I didn't. Wow, what is that you have there? We received Kalna's anklet. Here it's into the abyss. Having arrived in the sprawling waters of wrecked rock, you find yourself lost in thought, watching the horizon then.
Had enough sea-gazing there, sister?
Come on, there's always tomorrow. What leads you back to Wagon's cabin, where the others are waiting? Together, you share an entertaining conversation and a decent meal, courtesy of the lone minstrel who caught a fresh pack earlier. The companions gained hope. The Freedom Pact. We read the land of an impending doom but faced another of its kind. Oh, we know that we were trapped. Yet, for each danger which we faced, for every fatal ambush by Arch, we met with gentle souls and kindred spirits in the downside, who deserved more than to fade from memory within this land. It was then the stars themselves showed us the way, delineating a great voyage across the sea. Near broken it became, but then, at last, a moonlit vision, that of the rites, thus shall they say to, of us, the eight scribes gave their freedom so that we may yet have ours. The Hulk of Oes. The Darswaban was first of many river ships to vanish in the downside, although presumption of its loss were not inaccurate. The doomed ship and her valiant crew had charted half the Sea of Solis ere the end of their brave voyage. The Sea Titan, unfathomed Pluriness, was not fond of vessels sailing her sea, and split the doomed ship with a single swipe. The ship's own shattered prow would later end the Sea Titan's crewing, as the boastful Underking loves to recount. The stars themselves must have been moved by this, that point within the sea, now sacred, as the stars dance in homage every now and again. Oh, hey guys! Look, I got some here I think which maybe you would like. He shows you several bottles of multicolored liquids of some sort. Sun serum, star serum, and moon serum. Yeah, they taste pretty good, I guess. And besides, they can give you just the little lift you need. Know what I mean? You get thirsty for them, don't even worry, I can get some more soon. That's how you get a repeat customer there, Dad. You give him a deal. The afternoon is just beginning to give way to nightfall as you and your companions finish making preparation for the coming ride. Through all the ceremony, you realize Pamiha is nowhere to be found. The last anybody saw of her was shortly after the Black Wagon came to rest here at the Hulk of Ores. She returns just as you are beginning to plan a search for her. Sorry to have followed you there, living down. Just getting a little antsy is all. Had to go and spread my wings a bit and shake away the mess. She's holding something back. Don't you get in my head? I'm telling you the truth. I'm telling you the truth, damn it. Damn you, reader. Get out! Get out! Get out! Anyhow, it looks as if the show's about to start. I should be in the field with the others. As Pamiha departs, you see she's right, as the stars above begin to shine. You know she's about to face her sister, Pamiha, once again. You accept that it is a very private matter between them. Something else catches your notice in the sky. This time, strange news starts shimmering about the ones you recognize. The greater titans have returned. Some of them. A marrying spirit not in form, but those dark stars are a portent. Though they may light your way, beware the path they may illuminate, reader. Henceforth, you may invite the influence of the titan stars.
Behold the titan stars. Limbless Erezek. The Titan Stars, burning remnants of monstrosities felled by the scribes themselves. Dare you to stand against them in their fury? Dark is the knowledge that you seek there, reader. Best focus on your adversaries, keen as they are to confront you once again. Put out their fire first, and show them the glory of the Nightwings. Now then, make ready for the rite!
The winged exiles of the Essence take position opposite your own companions, and they lead us in a sales hustle. Pamiha, come forth, no trickery this time. She appeared as asked, though remains silent as her dead sister studies her for a time. Pamiha then reaches for her mask. You look weary to me, sister. Little sleep, I guess. I do get a little anxious sometimes on the night before one of these things. It can be a lot of pressure. Understandable. Two of them say nothing for a time. You cannot discern that what they are thinking. The Nightwing remnants all seem to be very mentally acute, trained as they are from their birth. Soon enough, Pamiha cuts through the tension, looking like us ever. So, even for the thought to make a proposal then? I have. And I think that this now is not the time for talk. Besides, your comrades there, surely you give them pause. Even now, they must be questioning loyalty. Caught it with the stunning Pamiha. It is very unbecoming, you know that. And you will be sure to tell those comrades of yours what you propose to me. She dons her mask once more. As she rejoins the other exiles of the Essence, Pamiha hesitates before returning to her group. I told her she could take my place, that I would keep her up to date about our progress, and that she could take my place if ever it was time for me to go. But you don't have to worry. For one thing, she refused, and for another, well, I'd better tell you later. For now, remember, you can count on me.
Who shall strive for freedom? Kanata. It is done.
Don't tell me when I get in the middle of this fight, but you got it, sister.
Face us, wasters of the Commonwealth. The pain and loss of the defeat this night shall reverberate not only in your whole hearts, but in the homeland that abandoned you. Are you quite sure it has to be this way then, sister? There is no compromise here, Tamiha. Not for traitors to my country or my blood. I understand. Then, so be it.
Commence! The first dousing.
We let down our guard this early on. Come, sister, pull yourself together.
Takes the plunge. I thought they had you there. Positively brutish. Such is the fury of the High-Wing Remnants. The imp did it! Careless. Yes, the Nightwings did prevail. And what a crushing victory it was! The ceremony is complete.
You win, Blood Sister. You win. I don't suppose that means we'll reconsider. You know that I cannot. You are always obstinate, but in that regard and all others which count for anything, you are inferior to me. Remember that. But your offer is meaningless to me. I shall free myself without your help or that of anyone. Now then, farewell. Wait, what of your comrades? The essence? You must meet them at least. Mindsing my words as ever, Panika. Know that I do love you in a way. Is that what you wish to hear? But my purpose is plain, and you stand in its way. You are fool to think my freedom is my goal. My freedom is a means toward an end like the likes of which you never would abide. Do you think that you could sway me from my purpose, Panika? Panika remained silent for some time.
Concilia.
No. I think that you will struggle to destroy the Commonwealth, no matter what it takes. no matter if in doing so we're destroying is destroyed instead. Just so. So then you understand me after all. Kamiko does not turn toward her blood sister apart.
The rites do tend to teach something of trust. Understanding deepens in the mind of the imp Tizo.
Tizo gives thanks to Harold the Swallow for watching over him and protecting him.
Until the next rite.
Back at the wagon, after prevailing over the essence in a decisive victory, you're about to join the others discussing the outcome when Wolfert finds you. Good work, but my girl. Though I'm afraid I must pull you away from any evil will. But there is something you should see. Please join me outside. Look forth, the golden star reveals itself to us once more. Indeed. Somewhere deep in the infinite dark, a single star shines brighter than the rest. The path to freedom reveals itself again. The rites are calling you again to the fall of Solium, where one among you may go free, should you prevail. It is as we discussed. The cycle of the rites is beginning to dawn more quickly, perhaps the scribes themselves have taken notice. Fortunately, having more frequent opportunities to free ourselves is not unwelcome to a plan. I suppose it's good for everyone, including the withdrawal, who will oppose us next. Waiting to Mount Alodiel, ought to be a little easier than before, at least. We should be able to make landing near to some of the old monuments of the scribes. Let's set forth at dawn. Soon everyone is off to rest, as best as they are able, knowing that another chance of liberty for one of them shall soon present itself. The greater titans. The stars shine strange beneath the sea. His window tries from the water so that he could see them plain, the burning essences of those who came before. Our lives are but a quest to join the stars. This one longed to be the brightest, but in the downside this one met those whose own star shall doubtless burn at least as hot. Together, we achieved great deeds. You may have seen some evidence of it, the remains of the greater titans, which once darkened this dark land, but in our kingship was the strength to conquer them. It is this most humble chart to chronicle those deeds, and may the Titan stars never stain the sky during your time. Umbless, Azire, Lindless, Arise. If this one is to be honest, he nearly expected his high-minded friend, lose Clorian ever to raise arms, and yet, it was Clorian alone who toppled the old titan, which befouled the serenity of waking mood. Clorian, he bought to bear the might of his entire family of willful saps, contained within his ancient gnarled staff. Soon did the poisoned soil of Limbless Azirek begin to dissipate. The old titan cried out a different vast cry, and with a speck. Azeroth yet lives, a husk, a single foul seed, still rotting where once something mighty stood. Sclorian, in his mercy, deigned that the surrounding woods ought to grow bold and strong by casting off the influence of Azeroth, not by forgetting him. The essence. The winged members of the Essence, each chosen by the matriarch, three statues, are living exemplars of liberty and piety. Would that my wings could be thus. Also, you of course must know, we all have wings. It is said that the men and women of the Empire relinquished theirs, drawn in by earthly matters as they were. But the harps, such as trees, that held tight the liberty their planet could afford. These divergent paths did cause a show of difference between the winged and the wingless over time. But here, in this land, our purposes are shared, our goals united. That then is the essence. What is who they are and what and why. Despite Panifa's mental condition, you can tell something is troubling him. She won't listen to a word I say, but warn them more. If she were my blood sister, I should think I'd hate her guts as much as she hates mine. He shakes her head. I should apologize to you and everyone. I sought after and felt out asking you to leave. Figured I would rather seek forgiveness and permission, you understand. My attempts with Panifa didn't amount to much, as you well saw. So at this point, I'm hopeful you'll be more accepting of Perkins than she. Though, tell me something, Rita Darling. Do you suppose I'm going to betray you? You may know better than I do at this point. Trust her. He expressed to Panifa that you do not view her efforts to make peace with Panifa as being contradictory to the group's larger goals. You understand why she did what she did. She says nothing for a while. That's kind of you to say, darling. May the others see it with such generosity. But if they don't, you need but tell me to depart and I'll be on my way. However, I've promised that I wish to make to you. Let me stay. And I'll see this through with all of you, no matter where we all end up. I'll be on the roof for a bit, I think. You take care too, darling. Despite Panifa's disappointment with the outcome of her confrontation with her blood sister, you sense she's less troubled now, after your brief conversation. Waking wound wisps. The wisp inside provides a scarce bit of light when it is needed, all for a loaf more quickly. Not moving it for now. Thank you and bye bye.